Archcraft is a unique Arch-based Linux distribution that offers a customized experience out of the box. But what are the things that make it stand out? Is it really that good? Are there room for improvements? This is Ankush from It's First, and here I talk more about my experience with Archcraft, what it does good or bad. First, the installation experience. Usually, installing Arch is not the most easiest thing to do. However, distributions take their own approach and try to make things better. Archcraft utilizes Calimeris installer for a hassle-free installation. You get the option to keep both OpenBox and BSPWM window managers by default. You can select just one and go with it as well. This applies for the standard free ISO available. So if you have purchased the premium ISO, it should feature other window managers like Sui. I think charging for a premium for certain desktop environments and more customization options is a good plan for sustainability. So you can explore the paid options if you like the free experience. Keeping that aside, the rest of the installation experience was one would expect with Calimeris. And finally, I was greeted into the login screen after restart. Second highlight about Archcraft is the user experience. Archcraft looks pretty when you get started. My preference is OpenBox Window Manager. So things like the widgets in the status bar look useful and make the desktop look lively. The terminal with ZSH shell, the workspace switching, scaling, and collapsing or expanding the window are nifty additions to the experience. And the best thing is that you can do it all using keyboard shortcut. Not to forget, if you head to its right-click menu, you will find lots of options including access to the system settings to tweak the display, themes, and more. The only weird thing I noticed in my case is my second monitor works only when I set it to 120Hz instead of 144. And if I leave my system unattended, the second display turns off until I reconfigure the display screen. Maybe it is just an NVIDIA specific issue for this distro, but something that can be addressed. I also tried setting up various icon packs to test the surface of customizations and options blew me away, which brings us to my third highlight to the distro, that is customization. Out of the box, you get plenty of pretty wallpapers that also look great in my dual monitor setup. Of course, it is not limited to just wallpapers. You can select from a range of custom styles from the preferences menu. Every style will change the look and feel of your polybar panel, icons, colors, window decorations, and cursor style as well. You can always come back to the default style if you do not like one of them. And if you want even more options, the paid ISOs will include a bunch more to have fun with. I would say it is worth every penny if you like having several options. And if you are not a fan of paying a fee, you can always customize things yourself. All you have to do is head to the polybar configuration file from your terminal and remove or add elements that you want in your polybar. Of course, if you do not know what you are doing, I suggest you to look through documentations before you attempt anything. A minor downside to all these customizations can be the upgrade experience. A recent upgrade broke some elements which was informed by the developer in a blog post along with fixes to that. However, that did not work fine for me. So I would suggest Archcraft to users with a little bit of Linux experience from this angle. And the last highlight applies to all kinds of Arch Linux distributions. The ability to install software packages and the presence of latest or greatest Linux kernel. At the moment, Archcraft does not have a GUI software manager, so you have to do it using the terminal or install per Mac manually. I would appreciate if it comes with it baked in. However, having the latest kernel release balances it out to some extent. I tried the free edition, so it combines OpenBox, ZSH, shell, and other styling. You can have a different tech stack with its paid ISO. Overall, Archcraft is a refreshing experience, but certainly has room for improvements. What do you think? Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below.